Welcome to my secret place devotion with Oyiks Alfred. The Word of God is alive and equipped to change your life.
Good morning. Psalm 118:15 says, "The shouts of joy and victory and the tents of the righteous, and the Lord's right hand has done mighty things." Father, thank you, O God. I ask that you stretch forth your mighty hand on behalf of your people today, Lord, that there will be shouts of victory, of joy, of thanksgiving in the lives of your people in Jesus' name. Amen. Good morning again and welcome. Today we're going to be answering another question sent in by one of our listeners, and we're going to respond to it from the scripture. It says, "Good morning, Rev. My question is, why do some Christians seem to experience one attack after another, even though there has been series of deliverance, prayers and fasting, breaking ancestral and generational strongholds, and live a righteous life, yet patterns are still being repeated?" Okay, so now the person here is talking about going through deliverance over period of time, and you see patterns being repeated. So I'm going to try very quickly to respond to this. The first thing you need to understand about going for a genuine deliverance session, I'm not talking about a fake one, but one where the name of Jesus is used to speak to demonic powers to lose their hold of the life of a Christian. When you do that, the Bible says that Jesus said that when the devil goes out, he will come back again. But let's go to the Bible to see the condition on which the demons will return. Matthew 12, 43 to 45 says, "When an evil spirit leaves a man, he goes into the desert seeking rest but finding none. Then it says, I will return to the person I came from. So he returns and finds its former house swept clean and in order. Then the spirit finds seven other spirits more evil than himself, and they all enter the person and live there. And so the person is worse off than before." That will be the experience of this generation. Now in this scripture, Jesus is explaining to us that when a demon leaves a man, that he will come back to check if the place is swept clean. What does it mean to be swept clean? There is no word of God in your life. There is no faith being built up in your life. Your life is basically just empty. That Christian is the kind that goes to church and comes back, goes to church and comes back, read the Bible, but doesn't just meditate on the word of God. The person's faith is not growing. The person doesn't even know his rights and privileges in Christ. Now, when the Bible says when your house is swept clean, there's no word of God, there's no faith, the Bible says the enemy will come back again. Now, what are you supposed to do after you have gone for deliverance? First thing is, you're going to have to feed yourself with the word of God. You have to ensure that your spirit man grows. You have to ensure that your faith grows. You have to ensure that you understand your rights and your privileges in Christ. The Bible is very clear. It says in Colossians 1:13, "Said, for he has rescued us from the dominion of darkness and brought us into the kingdom of his son he loves." Meaning that you are now in the kingdom of God. The enemy does not have a right in your life. If you see, you know, the enemy doing something in your life that you know is not according to the word of God, it is an illegal thing, and you have the right, you have the power, you have the authority to speak to the devil and tell him to leave you and your life alone, and he has no choice but to obey. However, I'm going to put a note here. According to the scripture in 1 John chapter 5, the Bible says in verse 18, "We know that God's children do not make a practice of sinning, for God's son holds them securely, and the evil one cannot touch them." Now, so the problem is, a lot of people live their lives in such a way that they attract the devil. The devil doesn't go everywhere. He doesn't visit everybody. If he sees that you're harboring sin on a perpetual basis, on a continuous basis, you're going to create the breeding ground for demonic powers. Bitterness, envy, jealousy, malice, unforgiveness. A lot of things that people do and retain in their hearts. You make the environment a breeding ground for Satan. You become like a magnet for demonic powers to come into your life and begin to harass you. But the Bible says that if you do not make a practice of sin, the evil one cannot touch you. Satan cannot touch you if you make sure that your house is clean and free from sin and all of that. See what the Bible says in 1 Peter chapter 5 verse 8. He says, "Stay alert, watch out for your great enemy, the devil. He prowls around like a roaring lion, looking for someone to devour." Why is he looking for someone? Because he knows he can't touch everyone. So he's looking for where there's a loophole. He's looking for where somebody has broken the hedge. What does it mean to break the hedge? The Bible tells us in Ecclesiastes chapter 10 verse 8 that if you break the head, the serpent will bite. What's he talking about? There is a hedge around every believer. Now, the devil cannot penetrate that hedge, but that hedge has to be broken. How is it broken? It is broken when you live in sin, or you live in rebellion, or you live in disobedience. You break the hedge and the Bible says the serpent will not bite. As long as you make sure the hedge is kept covered by the blood of Jesus, you know, and all of that, and by living his healthy spiritual life, the devil will not come close. So the Bible says he's looking for whom he would devour, because he knows he cannot devour everyone. He's just looking for where there's a loophole. He's looking for where the hedge has been broken, and then he'll be able to access and penetrate. That is why the Bible says you have to be on the alert. You have to be watchful. You know, don't allow bitterness, anger, or sin to dwell in your life. Make sure that on a daily basis, or not even on a daily basis, every morning, as most people do, but you know, if you do something wrong, don't wait till night or tomorrow morning. Confess immediately and genuinely repent. Don't allow unforgiveness and bitterness to stay in your heart. Don't allow malice to stay in your heart. If you do that, you're opening up yourself for the attack from the kingdom of darkness. You're opening up your life for things that have been chased out of your life to come back again. But the problem here is that Jesus said the devil doesn't always come back alone. He will make sure that he brings seven spirits more wicked, and that person's condition will be worse than it was at the beginning. So this is why a lot of times when people go through deliverance session, you see the same things they fought and won before coming back to their lives, because their lives is swept clean, no faith, no word of God, or they've gone back to start tampering with sin and putting their hands in muddy waters of sin and all of that. But if you obey these laws, you will be fine, and you will not see the repetitive patterns occurring in your life. Remember, your real lineage is not from whatever it is that's happening in your physical lineage from your father's house. Your real lineage, if you are a child of God, is from Jesus Christ. The Bible tells us very clearly that in the book of John chapter 1 verse 10, 11 and 12, he says, if I read directly from, okay, let's start from verse 12, he says, but to all who believed him and accepted him, he gave the right to become children of God. He said they are reborn, not with a physical birth resulting from human passions or plans, but a birth that comes from God. So if you read it from the NIV version, it says, yet to all who did receive him, to those who believe in his name, he gave the right to become children of God. So you're no more a child of darkness. You're no more just a child from your father's house, from the lineage and all the things that are repeating the patterns in your family line. The Bible says in verse 13, it says, children born not of natural descent, nor of a human decision, or of a husband's will, but of God. So you are now born of God. By repetitive patterns, I mean, you look at some families, you notice that their grandfather didn't, maybe he divorced or something, or they don't have children, or their children live to a certain age, or people don't live beyond a certain age. Their father, the same negative things are happening. And you look at your own life, you see the same negative patterns occurring in your life and that of your siblings. So that's the question the person is asking. What if you keep seeing those repetitive patterns? Repetitive patterns mean negative things that you notice that is prevalent in your family. So the Bible is saying that you have to recognize and understand that when you give your life to Christ, you have a new spiritual lineage, a new spiritual heritage, and you need to trace your heritage from Jesus and not from, you know, what was happening in your father's house. I hope you have been blessed and that you did learn something, and you now know the reason why, though the devil leaves, he comes back again. Thank you for listening. God bless you. Tomorrow we'll take another question. Perhaps you have a question you want answered as you've studied the Bible. Very simple. All you need to do is send me an email. The email address is questions@mentorsjournal.com. I'll receive and will respond in the course of this month. God bless you.
For other life-changing messages, you can now download the app Rev Oyiks Speaks from Play Store for Android phone users or Apple Store for iOS users. You can also follow us on Instagram, YouTube, and Telegram, all on the handle Oyiks Alfred.